So we're back for another show of strength, chapter 3. We're coming to you live from LaGrange, North Carolina. One of my cousins was getting married, so some of my family went down here. We started out the week in my gym. We moved it around a little bit. This is going to be my last week kind of dealing with just bodyweight exercises. Next week, I intend on moving into some regular template stuff with our dynamic day and a max effort day. My sciatic nerve and my back's a little jacked up right now, so I may maintain the conditioning really heavily on lower body days and just sticking to some assistance work. But for the upper body, we're going to go full go, dynamic day, and then we're going to get back in the shirt because I intend on hitting a bench only meet, I believe, in March sometime. So here's another little bit of conditioning. I did 10 rounds, 1 minute on, 30 seconds off jump rope. It was actually pretty intense. Just keeping that rhythm, staying locked in. It was nice. My calves were lit up. Here's Kyle with his overhead day. This was his 5-plus day, working with 160. Ended up hitting 10. He, too, is going to try to take the top spot in the bench-only meet. Right now, currently out of our family, I own the top spot with a 560-pound bench. He previously owned it with a 555-pound bench. But we're both going to go head-to-head, hopefully, on March 11th, and we're going to see who comes out on top. We're both looking forward to it. Once again, you're going to see coming up, we had Blair back in the gym. He's linked together two weeks of work, so it was pretty impressive. He ends up working here with 320, I believe. Real quick reps, he's a strong kid. He's always been still working, no belt. I don't know if that's because he left it in his car or because he intended to. I'm pretty sure he just left it in his belt or left it in his car, but just for him getting out and being able to bang around the weights a little bit is good. I know he's got a pretty hectic work schedule. And I know Kyle appreciates it, having a workout partner there for him. Here's Kyle's fives week, I believe. He ends up working with 420, I think. 425-ish, maybe. Bangs out some reps. Once again, he's working with the sumo stance to keep the wear and tear on his lower back down. Working with a sumo stance majority of the time will end up giving you a boost in your conventional stance. That's what we figured out here on the channel, but and same with Steve. Here's Steve. He's working with sumo still. Gonna keep pushing that up. He hit 260 for 5 sets of 1 on dynamic deadlift, and then he moved into some speed squats. He worked with 185 for 6 sets of 2. He's working with probably at the 12-inch box with a little bit of foam on it. Just working on keeping his knees out and having them not dip in. Him and Sam are on the same workout. They're both using Chad Wesley Smith's version of how he would do conjugate. The article is on his website. It's really good. It kind of uses the conjugate methods principles, but it also puts into work, you know, things that Chad Wesley Smith sees very important. Things like getting off the box, free squatting a lot of the time, and also, you know, using the core movements to how they are in competition. Here's my, whatever you want to call it, my lower body day. Like I said, I'm in North Carolina, so I had a Larry's Gym, it's called. It's not a bad gym. They have a ton of stuff. My back's a little it's bothered me a little bit, so I ended up using this hack squat machine. I don't even know how much it is. It's just 5 plates. I ended up stacking them up, doing sets of 5, supersetted that all with chins, and we hit some back extensions, some single leg RDLs after that. Here's Steve's dynamic upper day. He's working with 200 pounds for 6 sets of 3. He's always been a good bencher. This guy in the mirror, he doesn't know that guy. But he didn't intend on him to stand directly in front of the mirror like that, which is pretty funny. But he does a good job driving up through. His bench is going to explode, I think. By him mixing some things up and getting away from straight weight only, I think he's going to end up having a nice PR down the line. Here's Kyle. He changed it up also. His knee was bothering him a little bit. I think he took about 2 weeks off of squatting. He ends up using a box here, which I really like. It's only about a 12-inch box, and he has 395 here for 5. I think it's only going to help him. Kyle does a lot of bouncing out of the hole. He uses a lot of that stretch reflex, and by him putting a bench or a box down there, it's going to take that out of the game. So now he's going to really build that static overcome by dynamic movement, and hopefully it will produce some bigger numbers for him. I know he said it caught him off guard a little bit because he hasn't box squatted in so long, but having a change up, something like that, to throw into your toolbox and be able to use that type of just tool to make yourself better, and it's a safer squat. I mean, his knee was banged up, so getting on a box will help you out. Here's something that I'm going to try to alleviate some pain in my back with. Again, this is Stuart McGill recommendation. These are some dead bugs here. I just use a Bosa ball, and you're trying to exhale on the way down there and pinch that ball as hard as you can. Hopefully it resets your hips. I've also been doing the McGill's Big Three every morning for about 2 weeks now. Hoping to try to get some alignment back, some functionality there. Here is Steve. Steve's going through his max effort day. He had another really good day. He goes 335 for three. I know previously Steve would kind of be a little nervous repping heavier weights, but he does a good job here. His knees don't cave as much as they normally do, so it's something to work off of for him in the future. He ends up working with 365 here for a set of five off deficit. Then he follows it up with Sammy. Sammy had a great pull day here. I think last time he pulled, he ended up hitting like 45 for six or something along those lines. And this week he ends up hitting 500 for five. So he did a good job driving up through. We weren't there, but I definitely missed that atmosphere there at Show of Strength Saturdays. Looking forward to getting back to it next Saturday. And for Chris Hall, we put him at the end of the video because he needs a little of attention. Here is 405 for two. Finishes the lift strong. We'll see him next week. Stay safe. Stay strong.